All right, more problems. Go ahead and see what you can do. Square root 3 times square root 3 would be square root 9 or 3. How about that? Go ahead. 32 is 16 times 2. Square root 16 is 4. Or you can write it as 2 to the 5th. So 2 to the 2nd. And then 2 to the 1 half. And x to the 1 half. So that's what those powers are. Okay? And 2 squared is going to be 4. So that will be 4 square root 2x. All right, try that on your own. Oh, there's 243 there. What are we going to do there? So factor first, right? Use your factoring tree and get the factors and then simplify. So cube root means power third. So x to the 4 thirds, 3 to the 5 thirds, and rewrite it. So that one is that one, and then this 2 and 1 are these 2 and 1's powers. And then simplify. All right, try that one on your own. And tell me how we got that. 5 to the 3 thirds, that would be 5 to the 1. B to the 3 thirds, that's B to the 1. A to the 5th, so cube root of A to the 5th, that's A to the 5 thirds, which is 1 and 2 thirds. So A to the 1 and A to the 2 thirds is this radical right here. Well, how do we do that? Distributive property of multiplication over subtraction, use it. And also over addition, right? This multiplication distributes over both addition and subtraction. So 2 times 2 will be 4. 2 times negative square root 3 will be negative 2 times square root 3. 2 times square root 3 will be positive 2 times square root 3. And square root 3 times square root 3, positive square root 3 times negative square root 3 will be negative square root 9, which is 3. And you can see how 4 minus 3 is 1 in the middle term. You have like terms, add like terms. So those two just going to give you 0. 4 minus square root of 9, which is 3, give you 1. This is an interesting observation. Look, you have two radical terms, but when they multiply, there is no radical term. So 2 plus square root 3 is called the conjugate of 2 minus square root 3 and vice versa. All right, try that on your own. Pause the video here and go ahead and do that on your own. Remember, when it's odd root, the negative can be pulled out. 8 can be written as 2 to the 3rd, x to the 6th, cube root can be written as to the power 1 3rd, and then raise everything to the power 1 3rd. Simplify and you get those powers. Try that on your own now, same way. All right, factor everything out. So 128 is 2 to the 7th, which I've split as 2 to the 5th, and 2 to the 2nd, a to the 5th, a to the 1, b to the 10, b to the 2nd, so that the multiples of 5 are easy to simplify, because 5 fifths is 1, 5 fifths is 1, 10 fifths is 2. So those are these powers right here. What's left inside is 2 squared, a to the 1, b to the 2nd, that's 4ab squared, and that's the final answer. Okay, alternatively, what can we do? We can just factor everything, raise everything to the power, write that as mixed fractions, and then a 2 to the 1, that will be that, and 2 to the 2nd power, which will be in the radical, because that's what 2 to the 2 fifths mean. The 2 power is this power, the bottom 5 is this bottom 5. A to the power 1 fifth, so that'll be A to the power 1, and A to the power 1 fifth, so another A to the power 1 in the radical. So B to the 2nd, and B to the 2nd. So make sure you know where everything goes. All right. All right, try that on your own. Same way as we did the previous one. Pause the video, try it. Factor everything and simplify. 3 to the 4th, 4 over 4 is 1, and 6 over 4 is 1 and 2 fourths. So y to the 1 is out here and y to the 2nd is out in there. How about that? Make one big square root and multiply it out, then factor, and then simplify. How do I go from here to here? Square root 9 is 3, square root 2 will have to remain. Square root of x to the 5th, that's the same as 5 halves, which is 2 and a half. So x to the 2 is out there, and the 1 half power is the x to the 1 here. 7 halves is 3 and a half, so that's why y to the 3rd and y to the 1. All right, try that. We can make one big cube root, simplify inside. 2 goes into 16 8 times. This x to the negative 4 will come down here, make it positive x to the 4, and x to the negative 1 will give you x cubed. Y and y to the 7 will give you y to the 6. And now take cube root. So cube root of 8 is 2. Cube root of x cubed, which is 3 thirds, is 1. So x to the 1 and y to the 6 thirds, which is y to the 2nd. More problems. Now look what happened. Here we have a cube root and a square root. So you can't just make one root, because they're not the same roots. They're not the same exponents. So you'll have to just rewrite it. So 2 squared and 2 to the 3rd. And then rewrite the exponents as fractional power. So 2 to the 2 thirds and 2 to the 3 halves. Add the exponents. Fraction addition means make common denominator. And so now you have 2 to the 13 sixths, which is 2 to the 2nd. And 2 to the 1 sixth power, which will give you 4 sixth root of 2. So even though you started out with two different radical terms, you can make it one radical term. All right, try that on your own. Okay, so write everything as 3 to the power, add the fractions, and then write 3 to the power 1 and 1 15th. So that'll be 3 15th root of 3. Same thing, rewrite. You can do it this way. And then just add these powers. So that x and that x will give me x squared. And then continue like that. Or, you know, you could have just taken as x to the 5 thirds and x to the 6 fifths and combined the exponents by adding them, and then simplify and you'll get the same thing. All right, try this on your own.